When she was a Punahou freshman, class of 2010 alumna, Danielle Thompson took a class that changed her life. She recently came back to campus to share her experiences with the teacher of that inspirational class and his current students. Punavision was there and brings you this report.
This past summer, I spent 2 months studying abroad in Jordan at the University of Jordan in Amman, and for the first time in my life, I was an exchange student, and I was a little intimidated at first, but especially because they're kids my age, but it was an amazing experience because I was forced to learn the language and assimilate to their culture because I had to go to classes with them, and it was great because I got to see a new campus. I love libraries, and I studied in that the University of Jordan's library every day, and it was just a great experience to be part of another campus, but in such a far off part of the world. I got interested in Arabic studies because I've always been fascinated by the world, and when I started World Civilizations with Mr. Pierre, he showed us how interesting these different cultures of the world are, and I somehow was attracted to the Arab culture. I have no idea why, but it just seemed very exciting and different from the culture I'm used to. And he recommended that I went to a language camp in Minnesota the following summer where I would learn Arabic and, you know, learn more about the culture as well. I started learning Arabic intensively starting my first year of college at Boston University. That's when I, you know, started off at the beginning Arabic, and you don't learn about the culture there, it's just you're in the classroom and you just learn the grammar and the vocabulary, and I did that for 2 years now.
Danny will tell you that people keep asking, why Arabic studies? Arabic studies is very unusual. And it is, as Danny put it, I think, the path less taken. And I encourage students to take the path less taken.
I hope to use Arabic and my knowledge of the Middle East in the future by working for the United Nations or at the U.S. embassies abroad in the Middle East, or any organization that has some sort of tie to the Middle East.
I believe it's going to take young people like Danny, to not only understand the culture, but to be able to speak the language as well. And if they can speak the language and they understand the culture, then we are in a better position to deal with the conflict that is there. To walk into a situation, not understand the culture, not be able to speak the language, it hasn't prevented us from doing it in the past, and often the results haven't been the results we've been looking for. We can make a difference in the Middle East with more Arabic speakers, with more people who understand the culture.